Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us here tonight at Cardinal Spellman for our first ever virtual open house. My name is Dan Hodes. I'm president here at Cardinal Spellman. I am joined tonight, socially distanced, by Mr. Paul Kelly, our principal here at Cardinal Spellman. We're going to be leading you through this evening's events, and we're so excited about what we have in store for you tonight. First and foremost, I wanted to spend a couple minutes just talking to you about how successful we have been here at Cardinal Spellman in educating some of the best and brightest on the South Shore of Boston for the last 62 years. It's a great time right now to be a Cardinal because over the last 10 years, Cardinal Spellman has been investing so much in its infrastructure and in the life of our students and our faculty. About 7 years ago, we began some great facilities projects that span the life of the school and the life of the students. We worked hard to continue our projects through to completion this year. We built a brand new fitness center, science labs, dining hall. We've updated our auditorium and administrative wings. And most recently, we completed a 100,000 square foot turf facility for our students to excel in the athletic fields on. It's amazing how much we've been able to accomplish over the last 62 years here at Cardinal Spellman. But we're excited to share that with you tonight in so many ways. Not just how our students have excelled in academics and athletics, in the arts, but most importantly, how those students have learned to really maximize their potential here at Cardinal Spellman. It's a blessing for me here at Cardinal Spellman to steward the legacy of so many other Cardinals who've come before your students, and we look forward to them sharing their Spellman experience over the next 4 years with you as their parents, and obviously then with the many, many Cardinals to follow. We are positioned over the next 10 years for tremendous growth here at Cardinal Spellman. This year alone, we're up 13% in enrollment. We're excited to welcome all of our new Cardinals this year, and we're excited to welcome you to Cardinal Spellman to ask that question that you'll hear many times tonight. What will be your Spellman? I think the best way to express how we do what we do so well is to turn this over to Mr. Kelly, who I think is going to explain to us now a little bit more about what that life at Spellman is like on a daily basis. Mr. Kelly.
Thanks, Mr. Hodes, and thank you all for joining us tonight. Of course, we wish you could be here with us on campus. We hope that tonight's presentation gives you just a little glimpse into life at Spellman. I personally have been blessed to be the principal at this special school for the past 9 years, and I love being part of the Spellman family for so many reasons. You know, I think it always comes back to, at least for me, that Spellman is a place where everyone belongs. Everyone finds their place, everyone is respected, and truly, everyone is loved. You know, we're really committed here at Spellman to teaching to the whole person. And I know a lot of schools talk about that, mind, body, heart, and soul. But here at Spellman, we don't only talk about it, we live it out, we put it into action every day. We're very committed to that because in doing so, we hopefully are shaping confident and capable young men and women who are well prepared to go out into the world to make a difference. Now, as the principal, I'd like to speak about the academic program for just a couple of minutes. Our program of studies is designed to offer a wide variety of educational opportunities for our students to help them find personal success. Now, first and foremost, we are a college preparatory school, meaning that our goal is to help all of our students prepare them to be on track for a four-year college experience. In fact, 99% of our seniors go on to college, with 1% typically going into the military. Now, our students, you, are carefully placed at the level that will provide you with the most appropriate challenge for yourself and your ability level. We have CP level, which is college prep. We have honors level for those who are able to handle a bit of a more of a challenge. And eventually, for some students in the upper grades, we have what we call AP or advanced placement levels, offering a variety of college level courses for our students. In fact, we're currently offering over 10 AP courses, such as AP History, AP Biology and Chemistry, AP Psychology, AP English, AP Calculus, and even AP Art. Some of our students have favorite courses, including forensics, psychology, game design, statistics, even computer design. But our goal in every course is to create classes that are engaging, relevant, thought-provoking, and classes that prompt conversational exchanges to help our students develop life skills, skills like critical thinking, debating, analyzing, public speaking, confidence in stating their opinions, and becoming thoughtful and articulate leaders. So Spelman also offers a series of courses, which we call exploratory courses, which are designed to, like enrichment enhancement courses, to help enhance our curriculum, to make it well-rounded, to give an educational experience that is unique, student-centered, in classes like strength and conditioning in our beautiful fitness center, ASL, which is American Sign Language. Students love that course. SAT prep, personal finance, and several fine arts courses which we offer for our freshmen, including fundamentals of music, theater, dance, and visual arts. Now, I mentioned at the beginning that our commitment is to teach to the whole person. So getting involved is the key to creating a meaningful, rewarding high school experience. Over 85% of our students are involved in athletics, and our fine arts program is outstanding. I take personal pride in that because I have a lot to do with that as the director of the music, in addition to being the principal. Last year, we had over 80 students in our liturgy choir, and we had 100 students participate in our Christmas show and our spring musical. We also have over 30 clubs of all types of interests, including educational clubs like mock trial, debating, creative writing, book club, diversity and inclusion club, and our fine arts clubs such as step and dance, the choir and shows, as I mentioned, and symphonium, which is our a cappella choir. We have sports-related clubs like sports podcast, field hockey, and video game club, newsletter club, film club, and a brand new club which just got started this year called Broadcasting Club. The purpose, of course, is to connect kids to like-minded students, to develop lifelong friendships, and to create a high school experience that's meaningful and memorable. Ultimately, however, I would have to say that it is the spiritual opportunities that we offer here at Spelman that make Spelman so unique and special. Our campus ministry program is second to none. The prayer experiences that we offer offer opportunities for our students to develop a relationship with God and a bond with one another through their shared faith experiences. Our service programs take our students all across the world to serve those in need. Most importantly, though, we work at providing opportunities for our students to develop a personal relationship with God so that they will be armored for life. They will inevitably face challenges, but knowing that they're never alone because they have their faith. Their faith gives them hope, and hope always leads to finding a fulfilling and purposeful life. That, I think, is the greatest gift that Spelman can offer our students. And nobody, no school does it better than Spelman. So it's time now to hear from our faculty, the real unsung heroes who work directly with the students in and out of the classrooms. We are so blessed by them, by their commitment to the kids, and we're so proud of the gifts that they bring to our school and in turn share with your children. So let's meet a few of them now, our fantastic Spelman teachers.
One of the highlights of working here is the satisfaction and the pride that I take in the kids that have gone through the program. We have a variety of classes. Our kids go on to careers in science. I can't tell you the number of kids who are in medicine, in research, in physical therapy, EMTs, you name it. We have a kid in that field. It's amazing.
Thank you, Mrs. Davis. What a testament, really, Mr. Kelly, to, you know, not only how well our students are prepared for college, but how well they're prepared for life and for careers beyond high school and college. Mrs. Davis herself attended Cardinal Spelman, went on to college, and then returned here and has spent 42 wonderful years with us. It's a testament to the commitment that so many of our faculty members feel, not only to Cardinal Spelman, but to those students that come through our halls.
That's right. And, you know, the thing about our science department that's so incredible is they make the work very relevant, very hands-on, very exciting, lots of experiments. So the kids figure out, they ask the questions, why is this important? Right. And then how can I find the answers? And our teachers walk them through that so that the material is something that they own and that they're excited about. And that makes our science department so extraordinary.
It's not only limited to our science department, though, Mr. Kelly, as we know, right? It's part of every single part of the student's experience in all departments, not limited to science, but also art. Next, we're going to hear from our art department director, Lauren Savoia, who's going to talk to us a little bit about how that Spelman experience is lived in the arts.
Everything I ever learned about the world is because I'm an artist. I always talk about all of the life skills that you develop through the creative process and all the tools that you have in your tool belt. I'm not interested in just teaching technical skills to artists. I'm really interested in teaching them how to think creatively and also go through that creative process where they're developing those life skills.
You know, Ms. Savoia is also a graduate of Spelman, and she came back to share her love and her passion for the arts. And as you can see by the video, she brings so much more to it. It's not just about creating art, but it's about understanding art and understanding the impact that art has on us as individuals and as a culture, and how our lives are changed and enriched by the arts. We take that very seriously here at Spelman because we do believe that the arts fully enhance the full person, and no one does it better than Ms. Savoia.
Absolutely. I mean, Mr. Kelly, part of what we talk about all the time here at Spelman is that Renaissance experience of life, right? Our students are Renaissance people, and Mrs. Savoia last year decided to immerse our kids in that Renaissance over in Italy.
Yes.
She and a group of Spelman teachers really kind of wanted to bring that artistic experience home to the kids in the lived way by bringing them to where it's made. And certainly the Renaissance is alive and well at Cardinal Spelman.
For sure, and she is amazing. Another great, fantastic teacher we have is Ms. Collins, the head of our social studies department. So let's hear from her.
I really want to work with students on the skills outside of the classroom. How can they evaluate? How can they compare and contrast? How can they think critically? And more importantly, beyond the lessons of history, how can they take skills that are going to be applicable for the future? So that's really important to me as a teacher, is not just to teach the subject, but to teach skills that they're able to carry on with them as they leave my classroom and they go on to their next endeavor.
What many of you may not know, as I was talking to Mr. Kelly about this earlier tonight, Ms. Collins is not only an excellent U.S. history teacher here at Cardinal Spelman, but she has taken her own experience of history outside the classroom, as she does with all of her students. Last year alone, 22 of Ms. Collins' students passed the AP U.S. History exam. This was recognized by the College Board for its excellence in AP U.S. History teaching. And last year, she became an AP U.S. History reader on the national level. We're so proud to have her as our History Department Chair. And the work she does with our students continues to be unparalleled. We are so thankful for the work that she continues to do and is excited to do each and every day here at Cardinal Spelman.
Well, that's the thing. She loves what she does. She has tremendous passion for the content, and she loves teaching. She takes it so seriously. In fact, she pushes her students, sometimes to the point that they feel the challenge is a little overwhelming for them at first, until they recognize that she cares so much for them, she wants so much for them to succeed, and she will walk them through it, but hold the level of standards so high. And when they finish the year, they feel so accomplished because they made it through, and they're better students for life. As a result of what going through that her courses.
It's very true, Mr.
Spectacular.
Kelly.
Spectacular. Yeah, so we're going to switch it over now to our chaplain, Deacon Joe Nickley, who's going to talk a little bit about our campus ministry program.
What inspires me to teach is that I really want to share the good news with kids. I want to tell them in a painful, troubled world that there is hope. I want them to know and understand that when they are suffering, God cares and I care for them. And all the people here at Spelman, we have a tremendous faculty and staff that reaches out and offers each kid the comfort they need and deserve. We are here to love them. It's important that we share these great things with them each and every day.
Yeah, it's true. Deacon Joe is the best, and we're so blessed to have him here at Cardinal Spelman. In fact, he's been here for over 30 years, taking on many different roles as teacher, coach, chaplain, inspiration. And he continues to do that day after day, year after year. And he really is just a gift to us on a daily basis. And to this day, he's baptized so many of our graduates. He's married many of our graduates. He's officiated at their weddings, I should say. And he's baptized many of their children's, hundreds of them over the years. So the legacy of Deacon Joe is just tremendous. And he's just an amazing man.
Yeah, I would agree, Mr. Kelly. Essentially, Mr. Kelly points out the fact that Deacon Joe continues to spread the gospel, not only to our students here at Cardinal Spelman, but also to our alums through those baptisms and those weddings. Deacon Joe is, in fact, the good news that he hopes to spread. He's an incredible man, and we are so thankful for his service. We also are thankful for the service of not only Deacon Joe, but also Kathy Demers, our Theology Department Chair, and Jason DeRamo, who is our Campus Ministry Director, for their part and the work they do in continuing to grow the faith life of our students. Because as our mission statement says, we are a dynamically Catholic institution. Mm-hmm. And no one in the last perhaps 50 years of our life as Catholics was more dynamically Catholic than Pope John Paul II, who years ago quoted in his encyclical Fides et Ratio, that faith and reason are meant to exist together, that we do not abandon our reason when embracing our faith, and nor should we abandon our faith when embracing reason. And no part of our school is more reasonable than that led by Lindsay Ballard, who leads our math department. And so to help us reason our way through the math department, we're going to turn it over to Lindsay Ballard. Lindsay.
Spelman education can offer a student opportunity, can offer a student growth both in and out of the classroom, can offer a student a sense of home and a sense of acceptance. The students who have thought that they could never do math walk out of my room feeling like they can conquer anything.
As Ms. Ballard pointed out, here at Cardinal Spelman, we don't like to present students with challenges. We like to offer them opportunities for growth. And that is precisely what our mission statement leads us to believe and leads our students to do. To meet all challenges, to take on all comers, and most importantly, to grow themselves into the learners and leaders that the world needs. This is so true for our students, as you've seen throughout many of these vignettes. Our teachers are talking about the need for our students to respond to these challenges, to grow from these challenges, and when they leave the halls of Cardinal Spelman, to impact the world around them in a meaningful way. I think there's probably no other way to best end our time with our faculty today than with Mr. Gannon, Mr. Kelly.
Yeah, let's segue to Mr. Gannon, because he's going to talk a little bit about a student who had a very unique personal experience and sort of took so much of what she learned at Spelman and pulled it together in a way that was really something she was passionate about. And we offered her the opportunity to do that in a very unique way. And she's incredibly successful in pursuing this as her college major at this very moment.
A couple of years ago, I had a student come to me. She's interested in becoming a music producer, and we didn't really have a course that would, you know, give her the experience to do that. And so we created an independent study for her, in which she recorded and produced her own album, and it went viral. Now she's away doing exactly what she wanted to do, and we were able to give her the experience to do it.
And that student is in Nashville at this very moment living out her dream. And that dream really was nurtured here at Spelman because we helped her tailor make something that was she was passionate about and something that she wanted to do. Not every school is able to do that or willing to do that. We do that hopefully not just for that student, but for every student here at Spelman. And we take great pride in helping each individual maximize their potential.
Absolutely. I think nowhere is that more true than the lived experiences of our students here at Cardinal Spelman in crafting and curating their own curriculum. We've seen that a number of times tonight in the vignettes that our faculty have laid out for us, that these students that come to Cardinal Spelman, you students who hopefully will join us here at Cardinal Spelman, will have the opportunity to truly craft and curate your own Spelman experience. It's why I mentioned earlier in the evening that this whole video process tonight, this entire virtual open house, is really about you, and it's about your Spelman. We're here to hopefully express how much Spelman means to us, but also we have with us this evening a Spelman student and a couple of them who are excited beyond belief to spend some time with you expressing how much Spelman means to them, because this truly is their Spelman, and they want to share their experiences with you this evening. And so our own Abby Mack, senior here at Cardinal Spelman, is going to be leading us through a very unique and exciting top 10 list. And so at this point, I'm going to kick it over to Abby Mack. Abby.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here tonight at Open House, and thank you so much for that wonderful introduction, Mr. Hotz. My name is Abigail Mack, and I'm a senior here at Cardinal Spelman, and tonight I'm going to be leading you through the top 10 things that students here at Cardinal Spelman wish they knew before they entered their freshman year. And to help us out tonight, I have some of my friends here, and we're going to start off with Christian Wetzel, who is a junior. What do you have for us, Christian?
I wish I knew the importance of being involved in the Spelman community when I was an incoming freshman. I was able to meet new friends while doing sports and doing other extracurricular activities. It was so much fun. Most of the friends I have today as a junior are all met through these activities.
Thank you so much for that, Christian. The Spelman community is really important here. And one very big aspect of that community is the Spelman faith community. It's no surprise that Cardinal Spelman is a Catholic school, and that faith identity is something that we take very seriously, and I think seriously enough to count it as number 9 on our top 10 list. The faith community here is so strong, and I think that's what really strengthens the bonds between the students, because they care about each other as more than just their peers, because we share in something very deep and personal, our faith. And here to tell us more about the opportunities that we have to explore our faith at Cardinal Spelman is Senior Lily David. Take us away, Lily.
I wish I knew how fun Catholic Schools Week and retreat days would be. I anticipated a long day of silent prayer, but was very surprised when it was filled with fun activities. I still remember my freshman year when I was called up onto the auditorium stage to play a Guess the Song game, and I had so much fun.
Thank you so much for that information, Lily, on the Catholic events that we have here at Spelman. And that does bring us to number 7 on our list, that you don't have to be Catholic to come to Cardinal Spelman. Although we do have an emphasis on Catholicism with all of the Catholic events that we offer, we universally accept all students, because although we have Catholic events, we focus more on the morality, service, and just focusing on being a genuine, kind, and good person. And the events serve as a way for students to bond in ways that they wouldn't have at public schools. Which does bring us to number 6 on our list. Here is Emma to tell us about coming from a public school.
I wish I knew my freshman year that I wasn't alone. I came from a public school and I was not used to wearing a uniform or having stricter guidelines, which I was afraid of breaking. I wish I could tell myself, and I wish I could tell anyone that's watching this video that's in the same shoes I was, is that you won't be alone and you'll eventually settle in as time comes.
Thank you so much, Emma, for sharing about your public school experience. Fun fact, Emma and I actually came from the same public school, and that brings us into number 5. I feel like there is this myth going around that public schools have a larger curriculum because they are a larger school, but that is false. Cardinal Spelman, being a smaller private school, should not keep you from coming because you think that they might not have as many course options. Cardinal Spelman has a myriad of classes to choose from, all the way from electives up to AP courses. And one of the best parts is that if they don't have an AP class that you're looking for, or just any regular class that you have an interest in, you can do what is called virtual high school, or VHS. I've had the opportunity to tailor make my own schedule these past 2 years and take online courses in AP U.S. Government and Politics, as well as this year, AP Art History. And that brings us into tailor-making extracurriculars as well. So let's give it up to Brendan for number 4.
I wish I knew that if I wanted to start a new club that I could and I would be encouraged to. For example, a few years ago, my friend started the Sports Podcast Club where we record a sports podcast once a week or once every other week. And we invite a Spelman student on to talk about their sport. And at the end, we do a top 5. And I joined that club when he started it, and now I'm the producer and I run it with one of my friends.
Thank you so much for that, Brendan. And before we move on to number 3, I want to do a bit of a bonus while we're on the subject of Brendan. Brendan really epitomizes the Spelman student. He's on the Spelman golf team, he's a comedian on the stage, and is part of a very important club and AP classes. But no offense to you, Brendan, but his story is not unique. Spelman students are all very well-rounded. They're not afraid to be themselves. You'll see students go from AP classes to sports practice, then to rehearsals for the Spelman Christmas show, which I highly recommend that you join if you come to Spelman. There are no cliques here at Spelman because everyone is free to express themselves. And that takes us to number 3, because not only are our students well-rounded, but they are very well-traveled. Spelman offers international trips, both for fun and for service. We've gone to Jamaica and Ecuador to help those in need down there, and we've also gone just for fun all around Europe. Name a place, we've probably been there. And within the United States, for our underclassmen, we have a very exciting opportunity, the Appalachia Service Project, which has been going on for years, where students will go down, they'll get in the car and take a long car ride down to the Appalachian Mountains to help build homes down there. And to bring us back to Massachusetts, I know we all want to stay away, but for now, we're going to come back to number 2 with Erin to tell us about Spelman Spirit Fridays.
I wish I knew about Spirit Fridays when I came to Spelman. I love getting to dress down on Fridays and represent my sports teams or activities that I've been a part of while I've been here.
Thank you so much for that, Erin. And as much as I love my polo shirt that I'm wearing right now, Spelman Spirit Wear is a great way to celebrate Fridays. And sadly, that brings us to the last thing that I wish I knew on my list, and it is honestly my favorite. The bond between the students here and the faculty is stronger than anything that I've ever seen. It's so strong that even the phrase, "you were sent to the principal's office," has a new meaning, because students will pop into Mr. Kelly's office just to say hi. And the faculty here, especially the teachers, they care so much about the students. They will stay after school just to talk, they'll run clubs, and they'll run sports teams, and the bond here is just so strong, and it's really something amazing to watch, and it's an even greater thing to experience for yourself firsthand. And that wraps up the top 10 things that we wish we knew before coming to Cardinal Spelman. Back to you, Mr. Kelly and Mr. Hodes.
Thank you, Abby, and thank all you guys. You did a great job. You know, in the end, it's all about the kids. It's all about the students. That's why Spelman exists, really, because we take it very, very seriously to that. That is our commitment and our responsibility to shape students, to provide an opportunity, an experience here that is spectacular, but that goes beyond the 4 years here at school that prepare students for life. And so we think there's no place that does it better. We hope that you at home have caught a little glimpse of that, and we hope that in the end you decide that Spelman is your next place to land, and in fact that Spelman is your next place to call home.
Amen, Mr. Kelly. I think, you know, what we've learned tonight is how important Spelman is in the lives, the hearts of so many of our students, so many of our alumni, so many of our faculty. And we hope that that's been communicated to you at home, because what we're asking tonight is not just what is our Spelman, but what is your Spelman? Here tonight, you've seen so many of our students, our faculty, and of course, the love that Mr. Kelly and I have for this place. And we hope we communicated that to you this evening through this virtual open house. And we felt that there's no better way to end a virtual open house than a virtual tour of our campus. And so this evening, as we bid you adieu and we say goodnight to you and your families, we thank you for joining us tonight. We thank you for spending some time, some valuable time with us. And we look forward to seeing you here crafting your own Spelman experience. Thank you so much. God bless.
Good night. Thank you. God bless.
It is said that one can never truly know something until they experience it for themselves. The experience connects us, unites us, a shared moment in time that can be remembered forever. Cardinal Spelman High School has been creating those experiences for over 60 years on the South Shore of Boston for generations of Cardinals who have come seeking something true, something good, something beautiful. The tradition continues today with a new generation of Spelman students curating their own Spelman experience, building their own memories, and establishing friendships that will last a lifetime. These young Renaissance men and women are encouraged at Cardinal Spelman to explore new avenues of learning, new athletic adventures, and new artistic expressions every day, crafting their own Spelman experience.
The Spelman education is very unique. It's an education that strives and accomplishes and achieves to educate the whole person, mind, body, heart, and soul, for everyone who's looking to discover their best selves. My Spelman is a place where people are valued and loved and respected.
My Spelman experience has been extremely versatile, and Spelman has offered me anything that I could have imagined and more. They have cultivated my knack for the arts in a musical format. They have given me opportunities to take many advanced placement courses, and they have given me sports and clubs and everything under the sun, and they have allowed me to express all of my different interests and still have time to be a high schooler. My Spelman is commitment. You commit your whole self to the school for 4 years, and in turn, they will nurture every part of you and help you grow.
At Spelman, I got to meet like a bunch of new friends, people who I can like trust and speak to in a personal level, also a friendly level as well. I think the sports here are really great because you get to meet new people, you get to like open up to everyone here. I was varsity 4 years, and I became captain for soccer this year. And my Spelman is my family, because everyone here are my brothers and sisters to me.
So what will be your Spelman?